Welcome back guys to another video, and yesterday I did an experiment where I mined with Asominer connected to mining pool hub for 24 hours, and this was the result. The coins I mined were a little bit of Bitcoin, Bitcoin Gold, Digibyte, Skyn, Fedra coin and other ones. So I had 5 GTX's 1060 3GB version, 3 GTX's 1080 8GB, and I mined for half a day with GTX 180. So those were the GPUs used in this experiment. So you can see that I mined 10 different coins and I already exchanged some of them for Bitcoin. So I did this just to see how the exchange works, and this was the whole result. So you can see that I mined 0.021 Bitcoin Gold and I still have some unconfirmed balance. So the first number here is confirmed balance and this number here is unconfirmed balance. And this will be added to my confirmed balance just in like hour or two. So you can see that most of the coins that I mined on VIA GPUs are on Nicehash algorithm, and some of them are on Skyn like Digibyte, and some of them are on new script like Fedra coin or Maxcoin. So I wanted to see if it is actually worth the time spent to set up those miners and to just check them personally if they work, and to exchange all those coins manually to Bitcoin, or if you can just leave Nicehash and make better profits. So when something is more complicated like this is, it should actually give you more profits, but that was not actually a result. As you can see, I added all of those coins here in Excel spreadsheet, and you can see that I made $9.26. And if I would be mining with Nicehash for 24 hours, I would actually make $11.47 with the same GPUs. And how I got those numbers for Nicehash. So if you go to Nicehash profitability calculator and you enter GTX 1060 3GB version and click calculate, you can see that yesterday I would be making $0.95. So I would make 95 cents per GPU, and I just made about 20% less by mining with Asominer and mining pool hub. But remember that those earnings that I would make with Nicehash would automatically get converted to Bitcoin. But over here, as you can see, I still have a lot of those coins left in their original form. And if I want, I can convert them to Bitcoin or any other coin. But if I don't want to do that, I can just keep them like I will keep most of the coins. And why would I even want to keep some of those coins? It's actually because when the bull run happens on altcoins, like it is happening now for 1 week, altcoins often outperform Bitcoin. And the altcoins that outperform Bitcoin in those kinds of runs are the ones that you wanna keep. And for example, if I keep Vertcoin and I don't convert to Bitcoin like in a year or two or something like that, it would outperform Bitcoin like with 10-to-1 ratio, and if I decide to sell Vertcoin now, I would actually make 10 times more in Bitcoin than if I would just automatically convert it with Nicehash. So this is a 24-hour experiment, but I will also be mining for 6 more days and to see how everything performs in 1 week. So this is for 1 day. I made $9.26. But as altcoins continue to grow and outperform Bitcoin, this number should actually go up in average every single day. So some coins that I have here, I will automatically now trade into Bitcoin because there is no need to have them since they never outperform Bitcoin. For example, let's take a look at Bitcoin Gold. So BTG, Bitcoin Gold. So you can see that Bitcoin Gold got 12% growth yesterday, but most of the time it is just going down compared to Bitcoin, and this is no less than for 4 months. So it is up to you if you want to convert that or just keep it in Bitcoin Gold form, and I will most likely convert it just to Bitcoin. Next one is Digibyte, and if you take a look at Digibyte, you can see that Digibyte got only 0.85% growth yesterday. And in the last 1 year, it is mostly just falling down like it did in last 4 months. So the next coin I want to take a look is Fedra coin. So let's take a look at Fedra coin. And the same story is happening here. The Fedra coin cannot keep up with Bitcoin. As you can see, it is mostly at the same value as Bitcoin over here, or it is just falling down. So the only coins I want are the coins that are at the lowest time compared to Bitcoin right now and that have the biggest room to grow. So let's take a look at something like Zencash. So let's take a look at Zencash. So you can see that Zencash actually lost 4%. But Zencash is a really new coin. It is only about 1 year old and it has huge amounts of room to grow compared to Bitcoin Gold. Bitcoin Gold has market cap of 1 billion and this has market cap of only 125 billion. So maybe it would be better for me just to keep Zencash and coins like Zcoin, Zclassic and Zcash and just sell other ones to Bitcoin like I will most likely do. So by the end of week 1, we will see if I would just get better results by using Nicehash or by manually converting all of those coins and keeping some coins which can outperform Bitcoin. But if the difference will be only about 10%, then it might not be worth for you to do this and to keep track of all the coins that you have, to convert them every single day and to manually check on your records if they are actually mining or something went wrong. But if you have maybe like 1000 GPUs, then of course those 10% mean a lot to you, but with 10 or 20 GPUs that doesn't really matter so much. So hopefully I showed you something new and interesting today, and we will see in 6 more days if Nicehash is better than AwesomeMiner or vice versa. So thank you guys for watching, see you soon in another one, and bye.